Want to live in a historic dream castle? Then you are here at the right place. Stay tuned to know all the details about these abandoned mansions you could buy. Welcome back to another fascinating episode of Lord Luxury. Today, we are going to explore some beautiful abandoned mansions in the world that are on sale. Keep watching until the end to know the best buy. Are you ready for the journey? Some of these spooky-looking abandoned mansions could be turned into dreamy-look fairy tale mansions. However, most of these are left alone due to hidden dark secrets that prevail. Will you pull off from buying it? Without further ado, let us dive right into it. Number 1, Castello Diga. Imagine being able to live in an actual castle. Well, this impressive castle in Sicily, Italy is for sale for a whopping $1,200,000. Castello Diga is vast and spread around the area of 21,528 square feet. This magnificent ancient castle is set in 70,000 square meters of land in Ragusa, Italy's coldest region, close to Southeast Sicily. The castle also includes all the dreams you could imagine. It has a church, a Masseria country house, a turreted wall, and other lodgings. The total floor space of all the buildings is an impressive 2,000 square meters. The grounds comprise an olive grove and carob trees. However, as you can see inside, it has decayed since it has been left unattended. Parts of the castle are not so fairy tale, but of course, with some work, it could be perfect. The experts in the castle say restoring places like this would cost around $550 per square foot. So in total, we can see that it has a royal price tag attached to it. The site would be perfect for transforming it into a luxury private home, or alternatively, as a hotel, wellness center, etc. It is possible to buy a total of 650,000 square meters of land. Number 2, Elda Castle. Not all castles are in Europe. This magnificent mansion, left abandoned, is set amongst almost 50 acres of dense woodland, located in New York's Westchester County. The vast stone mansion was built and designed in the late 1920s by David Thomas Abercrombie, the co-founder of clothing giant Abercrombie & Fitch, and his wife, Lucy Abbott Kate. Elda Castle's title comprises the first letter of each couple's four children's birth order names. Long abandoned, the home has lost a fight with Mother Nature. However, the 4,337 square foot mansion is still undeniably enchanting. Once upon a time, this small, romantic home must have been the perfect country retreat for the Abercrombie family. Sadly, David Thomas Abercrombie's time at the property was short-lived, as he passed away in 1931 at the castle just a few years after its completion. The home features arched doorways, a cast iron spiral staircase, bespoke leaded windows, and an outdoor fireplace across several stories. There are a generous 25 rooms in total, plenty of space for a large family to stretch out. While several subsequent owners have tried to bring the crumbling castle back from the brink over the years, none have been successful, creating something of lore around the seemingly irreparable property. Since 2017, the estate has been on the market and it's now listed for $3.2 million. Here's hoping this fairy tale estate gets the happy ending it deserves. Number 3, Coombe Park. Coombe Park Estate is located on the northwest of the Oxfordshire village of Whitchurch on Thames near Pangbourne. With its 3/4 of a mile driveway, the Coombe Park Estate driveway to the main house through the mature parkland is a rare gem, less than 50 minutes journey from London. This extraordinary estate was created initially by James Gardiner in 1865. This mansion requires a new owner with a vision to shape the next chapter in its history. The property consists of a substantial country house requiring complete modernization, timber lodge, coach house, stud cottage, clock lodge, boathouse, stables, sports pavilion, indoor tennis court, paddocks, and woodlands. The mansion is spread on 125 acres of land. It had been left for 30 years untouched since the homeowners went bankrupt and the court seized the estate. It is on sale for $15,200,000. The sale of the Coon Park Estate is being handled jointly by Strutt and Parker and Knight Frank. Number 4. Glass House. Glass House is a large country house near the village of Maud's Meeburn in Cumbria. It was auctioned by Harmon Healy with a guide price of just $634,834. Glass House was reconstructed in 1851 for rich merchant brothers and tea and opium magnates Lancelot and Wilkinson Dent. No expense was spared in the home, with door handles shaped out of ivory and balustrades created out of French wrought iron. It was created by architects Mr. Gray and later by Mr. G. Mayer and was built in Italian style. It included furnishings by Gillows of Lancaster and London. It was traded in 2000 to singer-songwriter Christine Holmes and her husband, Paul Davies. They operated it as a performing arts school. After the couple divorced, Davies took charge of the mansion and became implicated with a gang of drug dealers in 2001. Paul was imprisoned for his part in the crime in September 2015 and since then has been up for sale in the market. Number 5. Mike Tyson's Lost Mansion. In the 1980s, Mike Tyson bought and moved into a 13,500 square foot mansion in Southington, Ohio. However, because of Mike Tyson's financial problems, he was forced to sell his 19,500 square foot mansion on 58 acres in Southington, Ohio, where he had resided since the 1980s. It was bought by a TV marketer for $1.3 million, but the guy never moved into it. The house sat vacant for years. After many years of being vacant, the mansion was bought by the Living World Sanctuary, who set about a 4-year restoration after passing through several hands. All the work on the vast property was done by the church's 150 members. The boxing legend's previous estate was donated to the church by the last owner, leaving Word Sanctuary responsible for paying about $50,000 in back taxes. The stunning conversion was turning Tyson's indoor pool and whirlpool room into a church. Next to the sanctuary is a vast main entry area full of beige-gray walls, dark woodwork, wrought iron railings, and a mini fountain. The space used to be Tyson's living room. The walls have been decorated with biblical quotes. All the indoor work at the estate is completed. However, landscaping and outdoor work still needs to be done, including a back patio area for weddings and events. When entering the property, a 1-acre lake sits on one side and a 2-acre lake sits on the other side, which adds to the estate's beauty. Remnants of the 54-year-old boxer's time remain, with the basketball court still intact. The old fireplace where Tyson used to display his titles has been turned into an indoor waterfall. At the same time, the 4-bay garage is now classrooms and a nursery. The tall steel cages where Tyson kept his 4 tigers have been dismantled for an outdoor pavilion. Trumbull County politician Ted Vanelli built the mansion in 1979 before he was convicted on corruption charges. These are some of the impressive mansions that had been renovated. Are you planning to spend some bucks and create a dreamy castle out of it? That has been it for the day. Which mansion had caught your eyes? If you had enough money, which one would you wish to buy? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to drop a like and smash that subscribe button for more exciting content. See you soon in the next video. Until then, adios amigos!